Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'd. Ahabati fillah, assalamu alaykum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's very important for us to be adherents of the haqqa, meaning that we adhere to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ma muwafiq li dhalik. So we only accept that which is coming from the book and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and the madhab of the salaf, and that which is in agreement with that. That should be what you're adhering to. It's not about being saying that you're a follower of this, you're a follower of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, you're a follower of Imam Muhammad ibn Wahhab, you're a follower of this. And what, there's so many nusus to show us that, that's what we're ordered to do. We're not, our asl is not that we're followers of Imam Abu Hanifa, or followers of Imam Malik bin Anas, or we're followers of Imam Shafi'i, or followers of Imam Ahmed bin Hanbal. But rather, we want to do our best to try to reform ourselves, reform our aqwal, our statements, reform our actions and so forth with that which is in accordance with the haqqa, which is in accordance with the truth. Now, I want you to listen to this statement with an open mind for those who hate Muhammad ibn al-Wahhab on how he dealt with his critics, what he had to say to them. It's a very excellent reminder, and show how the Sheikh was dealing with some of his khusumat, meaning those people who opposed him and disagreed with him. So he says, rahmatullah alayhi rahmatan wasi'a, he said, wa ana ushhidu Allah wal mala'ikatuhu wa ushhidukum ala dinillahi wa rasulihi anni muttabi'un li ahli al-'ilm wa ma ghaba anni min al-haq wa akhtatu fihi fabayyinu li wa ana ushhidu Allah anni aqbalu ala rasi wal ayn wa ruju' ila al haqq khayr min tamadi fil batil. Beautiful statement. He says, rahmatullahi alayhi rahmatin wasi'a, he says, and I bear witness and this is witnessed by Allah and his angels, and I call you to witness by the religion, based upon the religion of Allah and his messenger, that I am a follower of the people of knowledge, and whatever is absent from me from the haq, meaning whatever shortcomings I have regarding the truth, or that I made a mistake with regards to it, then please clarify it for me. And I ask Allah to witness that, and I by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will accept in totality, without hesitation, any clarification of his mistakes, and the return to the truth is better than to continue in falsehood. This is how that great Imam, rahmatullahi alayhi rahmatin wasi'a, how he was with regards to the truth. And that's how we should be, as in, we should be accepting. If someone criticizes you with something legitimate, it's a legitimate critique, not a critique based on batil. We don't leave the truth for batil. But if someone criticizes you with the haq, and especially if they do it in a respectful manner. But the fact is the haq, that we're ordered to follow the haq. We're not ordered to follow men. As the Salaf used to say, La yurith al-haq bil-rijal, walakin yurith al-rijal bil-haq. We don't, or kama qil, we don't know the truth by men, but we know men by the truth. So that's why we don't say we're followers of Sheikh so-and-so. I am a follower of this. Our imam is, we're followers of our imam. But rather we say we love the imams of Ahl-Sunnah throughout time. We follow them in that which is correct. Because again, we're ordered to follow that which is correct, which is the truth. Not imams. Because if the imam makes a mistake, all the children of Adam commit sins or commit mistakes, and the best of those are those who repent. You don't follow any imam in his mistake or anyone in their mistakes. You're ordered to follow the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qala subhanahu wa ta'ala fi kitabi al-kareem, amongst the many ayat, وَعَتِيُ اللَّهُ وَعَتِيُ رَسُولُ. Obey Allah and obey His Messenger. صلى الله عليه وسلم وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.